Japan's public broadcaster NHK opened its doors on Monday to preview tech projects that might change what you see on TV. Providing a new way to look at water sports is the Twins Cam. Traditional sports coverage of events like synchronized swimming switch between cameras above and underwater. It's not possible to use a single camera to capture all the action because of the different way that light refracts in air and water. This half-submerged camera is pointing at a circle, but this is what it shows. The above and underwater parts of the image don't match up. But the Twins Cam allows for something new. Two cameras, one underwater and one above water, have their zoom and focus synchronized, so they produce a single, realistic image. The result is a never-before-seen view of synchronized swimming. NHK used the system at last year's Japan Open Synchronized Swimming Championship and hopes it will be used at next year's London Olympics. When broadcasting goes on the road, it usually means big trucks like this, but that's changing. This electric car, based on a Mitsubishi iMiV, has all the equipment needed to support and switch up to four video sources and send back a live signal to the TV station. The car battery provides a range of 100 kilometers, and a second battery will power the equipment for up to 2 hours. Calling it cramped might be an understatement, but the car will allow NHK to broadcast from residential areas where trucks can't go because of noise or narrow streets, from places like temples that demand quiet, or during early morning shows where engine noise might otherwise wake neighbors. And the SkyMap system brings a Google Earth-like feel to live television. Alongside the video feed from a news helicopter, the system sends GPS data and details on the camera's direction and zoom. A computer then places a virtual camera in the same position on a 3D mapping system. The labels are separated from the map and overlaid onto the live broadcast. NHK expects SkyMap will be useful during live news, especially when covering things like earthquakes, when helicopters are frequently used for initial coverage and where landmarks might not be immediately obvious. In Tokyo, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.